Someone asked me about the moment to force ratio and what does it mean in orthodontics. Very, very fast little video to try to explain. So if you put a force F at the bracket away from the center resistance, there is a distance, in this case 10 millimeters. If you calculate the force system at the center resistance, you will get the same force F that was at the bracket, so it's this force, but because the force is away from the center resistance, you will get a moment, and the moment to force ratio in this case is M over F equals to 10, because the moment equals F times D, which means that M over F equals 10 in this case. Let's assume now for a moment that we have now incorporated a wire that is 4 millimeters away and has this different shape. So now what happens is the distance, which was 10 millimeters, becomes 6 millimeters, or D2. The same force is found at the center resistance, so F here is the same force as F here, and you will have also a moment given by the force F right here, but this time M2, which I call M2, equals that F times D, or M over F equals 6 millimeters. So by varying the line of action of the force, which is right here, that is the line of action of the force. In the first example, the line of action was there. In the second example, the line of action was here. And what happened in the first example, the moment to force ratio was equal to 10. And in the second example, the moment to force ratio was equal to 6. So in conclusion, varying the point of application and the line of action of the force will have a significant influence on the moment to force ratio. Thank you.